Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX launched the Starlink 610 mission successfully on a Falcon 9 rocket.
2, 1, ignition, engine full power, and liftoff of Starlink 610. Go Starlink, go Falcon.
The booster which launched this mission, B1067, then landed successfully for the 13th time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
There's confirmation that the stage 1
landing gear is in terminal guidance.
Has started in preparation for a touchdown on our drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
This Falcon 9 first stage has now successfully launched and landed for the 13th time.
SpaceX were planning to launch another Starlink mission just hours later, but that was postponed. The Starlink 7-1 mission is now scheduled for Tuesday 22nd at 6:04 a.m. UTC or 2:04 a.m. EDT. We can also hopefully expect another Starlink mission to launch this coming week. The Starlink 611 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 23rd at 12:47 a.m. UTC or Tuesday 22nd at 8:47 p.m. EDT. A bit later in the week, we can also hopefully expect to see another Falcon 9 launch, this one carrying astronauts. The Crew 7 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 25th at 7:49 a.m. UTC or 3:49 a.m. EDT. SpaceX posted pictures related to this crew mission. They said Crew 7's Dragon arrived at Pad 39A in Florida ahead of its third mission to the space station. As teams prepare to launch Crew 7 and safely bring Crew 6 home, the Crew 8 astronauts completed their first week of training in California. There was an interesting article posted. It says SpaceX turned a profit during the first quarter due to surging revenue, the Wall Street Journal reported Thursday, citing documents detailing the privately held company's quarterly and annual results. There was an article posted related to a contract awarded to SpaceX and others. It says SpaceX, Kuiper Government Solutions and Elyria Technologies were selected for market research studies on how commercial systems could add capacity to the military's future low Earth orbit constellation. There was an interesting article posted related to a future crew mission. It says Poland has become the second European Space Agency member state to reach an agreement to fly an astronaut on a private mission to the International Space Station. Axiom Space said August 9th it signed an agreement with Poland in cooperation with ESA to fly an astronaut from that nation on a future mission to the ISS. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of a recent water deluge system test. This new Mega Bay bridge crane was seen being moved in the production yard. The tent number 2 in the yard has been seen being disassembled from inside as they look to expand Star Factory. Here's a view of the tent also being demolished. SpaceX posted a really cool video of a Raptor engine firing. They said, long duration test fire of Raptor while gimbaled 15 degrees. In response to this, Zach Golden said, wish they would have shared what the purpose of this was. Still awesome though. Musk responded with landing burn max gimbal deflection. This Raptor vacuum engine numbered SN235 was spotted in the yard. Work continues on Starship 28 with Raptor engines currently being installed. Ship 29 continues to be worked on inside the high bay. The hot staging ring for Booster 9 was lifted to be installed recently. SpaceX posted these cool pictures of the Booster 9 prototype in the Mega Bay. They said, vented interstage and heat shield installed atop Booster 9. Starship and Super Heavy are being upgraded to use a separation method called hot staging where Starship's second stage engines will ignite to push the ship away from the booster. Booster 10 was seen being moved from the rocket garden to the Mega Bay. To finish up the video today, I want to take a look at the Cameron County website where there are a bunch of possible closures for this coming week. There is currently a primary closure scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 21st, with alternative dates on Tuesday 22nd and Wednesday 23rd. As always, I have to say thanks to both Jack Beyer and Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.